It is the best of times, it is the worst of times, but we're going to celebrate the best of times. There is a complete explanation now as to why we don't need explanations. And so that's tremendous. We pray for presence, because presence is direct knowing of what we are. Does God need anyone to explain to God what God is? And if so, what would that possibly be? Does God creations, the creations of God, do they need to have it explained to them what they are? Or do they know what they are? Does God know what God's creations? Does God know the creations? Or does God have to say, oh, I don't know my creations. Can someone explain them to me? I don't understand. Can you explain them to me? Who's going to do the explaining to God? If you have your eyes closed and there's a picture and you have substance, you tell someone, explain the picture to me. And they explain, and they say, I don't get it. Open your eyes and see the picture. And then you say, oh, I see what it is. So, of course God knows all of creation directly without the need for any explanation. And there's no one to explain to God what any of that. So, what we are doesn't need any explanation. And yet, what we're doing is we're trying to explain to ourselves what we are. We're having the mind explained to us instead of knowing what we are. And so there's been a complete explanation of why we don't need explanations. I did it in the previous video. Presence is primary. And it's a great thing to have that now, because we are at the 4444 date now. It's on the 20th, it will be that. If you look at the swastika, the right-facing swastika, the clockwise swastika, you will see, if you trace it, there are four fours. Four fours make up the swastika. And if you look at the date of May 20th, 2013, you will find the 44th president of the United States has been in office 4 years and 4 months. So there's four fours there. It's a very actually symbolic date, May 20th. That was when the real swearing-in ceremony. The public one was done the 21st, but the actual legal one was done the 20th by the Chief Justice in the Oval Office, I believe, the White House. So now we'll have four fours, the swastika, on May 20th. What does it mean? Well, it means a lot, actually. And it's a very, very good thing that we have the complete explanation of why we don't need explanations for what we are. Because the four fours actually symbolizes the fourth dimension. The fourth dimension is that which has sophisticated explanations for what we are. And those who believe they need an explanation for what they are will embrace the fourth dimension. And embracing the fourth dimension is embracing a slow boat to nowhere. Because you will become very arrogant in thinking that you know what you are based on explanations. That is the problem. That is really the problem. It's like your eyes are closed and you're calculating, figuring like a blind person, and you insist that this is the height of knowing, of spirituality, of being, because you have better explanations for what you are. So it's actually, fourth dimension heightens delusion, heightens it. So we are going into what I see, a pushed, P-U-T-C-H, I can't even say that. Where the fourth dimension is going to make a push. Now, what I've seen is that the conservative, the right wing, the conservatives in the world, etc., are going to be broken. They're going to be crushed. Somehow, they're going to snap. They're going to be broken. They're going to be crushed. After that is going to come impact of some space rocks. But the situation is the fourth dimension is now going to make their push. The last couple weeks that the third dimension, the right wing, has been trying to break the fourth dimension here on this planet. They thought they had a way to do it. No, they did not. They did not. And it's going to backlash on them. So we have a situation now where people will be expected to accept sophisticated explanations for what they are. And that will be like a law. It will become the law of the land, as it were. And the idea of knowing who we are directly, without any need for explanation, will become criminalized, basically. So it is a momentous time, actually, on this planet. I see May 20th as the most momentous time. And I've been pushing like crazy to get to this point where I have a total viewpoint of why explanations aren't needed. A complete explanation of why we don't need explanations, which I've been able to do. I've been able to do that. I feel very comfortable with it. It's a tremendous breakthrough. Explaining how mind is parsing out its own annihilation bit by bit by bit by bit. We call this loss. And it, bit by bit by bit, it's explaining, it says it's explaining annihilation, so we get used to it, but it's really parsing it out bit by bit by bit, because we cannot stand the total annihilation of mind. Spirit says, no, I can't stand that, because I won't know what I am. I won't be able to experience what I am, as it were. Okay. So, because we're based on experiencing, Spirit is based on experiencing, so is God. And the experiencing is the completion of creation. Okay. So if the method of experiencing the mind were annihilated, there'd be no completion of creation, as it were. So when Spirit chooses to be prime creator, says, I want to be prime creator, it means it wants to change reality, which means really it's going to annihilate itself. And so mind presents that idea as mind being annihilated. Mind says, okay, mind being the presenter says, I am being annihilated, mind. And Spirit says, no, don't do that, I can't stand that. And so mind says, no problem, I'll present the annihilation bit by bit by bit in a past, in time. So you have this gradual loss going along in time. And we're supposedly trying to get used to that so we can eventually withstand the annihilation of mind, which would be Spirit's annihilation too. So we are addicted to explanations of what we are. We don't want to see the total direct knowing of what we are right now, because we think right now means experiencing total annihilation right now. We're addicted to time. And so therefore we're addicted to explanations of what we are. Partial incompleteness, which we don't really need at all, but we think we need it. You know, so there is this confusion. And anyway, I have the complete explanation. I understand it totally, all the way around, no problem at all. The point is that we are in a time now where we're either going to choose more explanation, or we're going to decide, hey, we don't need any explanation of what we are, because God knows us directly. We can know ourselves directly without the agency of explanation. What we are is something that is directly revealed to us. What we are is directly revealed to us. Our experiencing is direct, is immediate. So those are the two choices. Either we demand that it be explained what we are, we decide to accept direct revelation of what we are. That's the difference between the fourth and fifth dimensions. Okay, so those who continue to demand that they be, that what they are be explained to them, will go into the fourth dimension from this point forward. And those who decide that they are willing to accept direct revelation of what they are will go to the fifth dimension. That's very simple. Going forward, as the Earth is definitely going to experience catastrophes, from what I've seen. I've always, from the day I was born, I was always aware that there's going to be space rocks are going to impact the Earth at some point. And it's looking more and more that way. It's very funny, after I did these videos of talking about, I believe there's going to be some space rocks impacting the planet, suddenly in the news, the media, they start talking about, oh, by the way, the moon was impacted by this meteorite recently, and there's a gigantic explosion on the moon, equivalent to, what is it, 5 tons of TNT or something. And we could see it, it was so bright, if people looking at the moon saw this flash on the moon. And oh, by the way, and then of course, previously there was someone from NASA, the head of NASA, saying, oh, by the way, if New York happened to be hit by a meteorite, what could we do? And the head of NASA said, well, all we could do would be pray. That's it. And now they're talking about an asteroid that's supposedly on a collision course with planet Earth. All these stories suddenly bubbling up now. Just after I mentioned what's coming down. So there's definitely something going on here. I mean, there's awareness at some level of intention of something that there is likely to be some space rocks coming in, incoming, and we're being prepared for it. The planet's being prepared for it. So what I see is the third dimensional planet is going to go through catastrophe. Many people will shift to the fourth dimension, which is again the pursuit of explanation of what we are, and many will shift to the fifth dimensional planet, where there's no need for any explanation of what we are. We directly experience what we are, directly experience it, directly know what we are. How great is that? Gone is all this mental conflict, all these concepts, all these words, all these thinking, figuring, all this stuff. We directly know what we are. That's the fifth dimension. So we are really on the cusp of the fifth dimension at this point, because there will be, starting May 20th, there is going to be a push now towards the fourth dimension on this planet, fourth dimensional shift on this planet. The consciousness will crystallize, and the old third dimensional consciousness is going to be broken. Conservatives basically represent a third dimensional consciousness which doesn't want too much explanation. They want freedom of exploration of what they are and not too much explanation. Fourth dimension wants to be a very uniform, controlled explanation of what we are, thinking that's more sophisticated, it's better. Whereas the fifth dimension realizes we don't need any explanation of what we are. In fact, explanations will never suffice. It's all fear-based. The explanation of what we are is fear-based, actually. So the third dimensional consciousness of this planet is going to be broken very soon. Again, that is the consciousness of saying we don't know who we are, we're searching for explanations, but we don't want too much explanation. We want to have freedom to seek, freedom of seeking at what we are. And so there's a feeling of wanting freedom, of wanting individuality, of wanting to be able to freewheel it. Whereas the fourth dimension is not like that at all. It's extreme control and regimentation, regulation, tremendous amount of regulation, data collected on everybody, and there's a uniform kind of feeling of like a hive mind where everybody agrees to the same explanation of what they are, etc. They try to get everybody on the same page, as it were. So very different. The fourth and the third are very, very different. That's why the third dimensional consciousness doesn't like the fourth at all. They say, whoa, you know, we like our freedom. We want to be able to consider what we are, consider any sort of explanation. We don't want to be bound to any particular explanation. Whereas the fourth, they want to have a top-down bureaucratic explanation, a one-world religion, a one teaching. Everybody is getting the same, spoon-fed the same explanation of what they are. Whereas the fifth, complete freedom of experience, because everyone knows what they are. Free of all explanation is that everyone knows the one, the oneness. Everyone knows, directly knows. And that's fantastic, wonderful. So we are now at the crossroads. We're now at the crossroads. Four fours, four fours. We are now at that point. Fourth dimensionals will now take over the consciousness of this planet in preparation for a dimensional shift, probably. Again, the third dimension of this planet is going to be remodeled. Actually, the planet is going to be remodeled through all sorts of cosmic catastrophes coming. That is the picture that has been presented. That's what I've always known for my entire life. And we may not even know, you know, we may be going to fourth dimension and we not even know it. Not even know it. The third dimension will have sort of dropped away, as it were, and sort of disintegrate and disappear. I mean, we don't even aware of the situation. How it happens from the perceptual standpoint is difficult to describe, really. So we may be in a world where catastrophes don't happen so much. There may be some, but then it seems not so much. That's a fourth dimensional. Well, we'll have shifted into fourth dimension. Now you're aware that the third dimensional planet is actually experiencing tremendous catastrophe and remodeling. And we may not even, it's possible we may not even be aware of it in a fourth dimensional situation. And then those in the fifth dimension, they may experience something a little different. They may experience some kind of ascension, a relocation to a fifth dimensional experience. That is what we have in store for us now. Right now, we're at it. We've reached it. We've reached the crossroads. The 4-4s, the swastika, May 20th, 2013. It's very interesting that fellow Harold Camping from the family radio in Oakland was put up all those billboards. What did he say? I may have said March. I said May 21st, 2011, end of the world. May 21st, very interesting. And he said he figured it out from the Bible, you know, some calculations or something. But actually, May 21st actually turns out to be the 4-4s, okay? And the close of the third dimensional cycle, actually. So in some ways, you know, it may have been off a couple years. But the date, May 21st, is actually quite accurate. Is that we are entering into fourth dimensional situation now. And the third dimension really has, by all intents and purposes, come to an end. Again, the last several weeks, I said May is crucial. And what happened is, again, the third dimension tried to break the fourth dimensional grip on this planet by the scandals, all the scandals that came up all at once, three big scandals, you know. And interesting, number three, right? The Benghazi thing, the AP wiretapping, and the IRS scandal, those scandals all came together, three scandals. And, you know, it's basically going to be much ado about nothing. It's not going to get anywhere at all. It's obvious. So the fourth dimensional says, it's nothing. Yesterday's news. Nothing to see here. Move on. And that's what's going to happen. So the third tried to break the fourth. It didn't work. And that's it. It's over. So expect the fourth dimensional consciousness now to crystallize on this planet. And at the same time, expect the fifth dimensional presence to be here at this time. So that is why it's such a great time. Expect the fifth dimensional presence to be here now also. The actual presence, the I Am presence, meaning that which knows what they are, knows identity, knows spiritual identity. I am that I am. Without the need of any explanation, without demanding any explanation, direct revelation of identity. Direct revelation of identity. That's the fifth dimensional presence. And that should be here. I expect it to be here. And at that time, we can be reassured that we are what God created. We are exactly what God created. We are totally free, totally eternal and invulnerable. Eternal life, not this temporary charade, but eternal life. We've never left our identity. We've never left home. We've never left reality. We are only dreaming that we did, as it were. That's shorthand for what happened. Presence, fifth dimensional presence, should be coming to the open now for those who are going to go to the fifth dimensional awareness of knowing who we are and not demanding explanation for what we are. Knowing instead of explaining. Right? Knowing, direct knowing. So again, it is the most consequential of times right now. And it's been a struggle to get here for sure. But here we are. And congratulations to everybody. This is the time now. These are the times that we have struggled to get to. Because here the opportunities now become manifest to us. And the opportunity to be truly boosted into knowing what we are instead of having it explained to us what we are. See, we're demanding an explanation of what we are. We can drop that demand now, understanding where it came from. So that's a legitimate usage of words and concepts and explanations to explain where it came from and why we don't need it and how we can set it down. That's a legitimate usage. It was amazing. I woke up this morning and I was contemplating and asking for clarification, and suddenly the Holy Spirit, it came into my mind, what is the swastika? Is there not a four there when you trace it? Is there not a four? I said, yeah, there is. You go like this, and then a straight line down, the axis like that, and there's a four. And they said, how many fours? And I went around, I said, well, there's four fours. I said, wow, that's amazing. I never think about stuff like that. It just came into my mind. How? So it is relevant, of course. The Nazi Germany was a fourth dimensional push into this world. Okay, and keep in mind that the fourth dimension that was seeded into Germany, many, many, many of those people, those scientists and fourth dimensional mindset, moved throughout the world. Many of them coming to the United States of America, actually. They fled. And they brought with them, they also brought with them the Prussian, you know, educational system was spread throughout the world. The fourth dimensional educational system has been spread throughout the world. It basically, the fourth dimension really touched down in this world in Germany. And Germany was way ahead of the rest of the world. And which is why they got the notion of the super race. They saw that they were so far advanced in fourth dimensionality. And so then much of that got transferred over to the United States. The whole space program, the missile program, the nuclear program. I mean, Einstein was born in Germany. All this fourth dimensionality, understanding of that, got transferred into mostly the United States. And the United States then developed all this fourth dimensional infrastructure that we have, high technology that we have today. That's where it came from. The pharmaceutical industry, all that stuff. So we already know that fourth dimensionals, how they function, they want to be seen as superior to third dimension, for sure. They want to have things regimented, for sure. They want to get rid of anything that is freewheeling and not controllable, for sure. And we know how they operate. And we know that they have that the swastika is their symbol, four fours. And now we know today, May 20th, four fours, present number 44, 4 years, 4 months in office, okay? Four fours. Very much fourth dimensional. This administration is extremely fourth dimensional. And the planet has been conformed through the fourth dimensional educational system that also came out of Germany. Spread throughout the world, this whole thing is designed to give sophisticated, complex explanations for what we are, okay? That's fourth dimension. But what we are can never be explained to us. We're completely beyond any explanation that could ever be given. What we are can only be revealed to us. So all this stuff is literally just a dead end. It's just a side trip in a dead end. Fourth dimension. It's just a gigantic waste of time. Gigantic waste of time. So you have had fifth dimensionals here on this planet explaining this to you. I've always been an advocate for the fifth dimension. And there have been many in this planet who have been explaining, hey, you know, not becoming but being. All right, not becoming but being. Direct seeing. That's Advaita, Zen, all the stuff. Direct seeing. All right, direct seeing. I agree with all of that. It's just that my job was to give an overall context, an explanation of why we don't need explanations. And then, but these other teachings, or fifth dimensional teachings, direct seeing. In other words, let it be revealed to me what I am directly, instead of an explanation. As my experiencing is direct, instead of it having some intermediary that's explaining it to me of what it is that I'm supposed to be experiencing, an explanation. So there's been a lot of that. There's been a lot of teaching on in this world around direct seeing, about directly knowing what I am. Being, knowing being instead of becoming. Becoming is an explanation. It's a stalling tactic. It's a cover story. A cover story. Which reassures us as we actually experience gradual loss, gradual loss, gradual loss, gradual loss, trying to get used to loss, and so that we can get used to the mind completely vanishing, being completely annihilated, which we can never get used to it, because that is necessary. Mind is necessary for our experiencing. It's necessary for spirit to experience, to have mind. So the annihilation of mind is completely unacceptable to spirit, completely unacceptable. And can never accept it. That is a fact. And when we choose the idea of wanting to be prime creator, mind literally has to present that to us as mind being annihilated. Literally. So, and we say, no. That cannot have that. And so then mind has to present this gradual annihilation to try to help spirit get used to being without mind. That's the whole purpose of existence, to get spirit used to being without mind. Kind of weaning, it's really a way of trying to wean spirit away from mind so that spirit can function without mind at all, which is impossible, completely impossible. So it's always the time, which I say, choose a new idea. Choose a new idea, the idea of not trying to be prime creator. You don't need to have the mind symbolize its annihilation. You don't need time, you don't need explanation, that having what you are explained to you. Because of course, if there's no mind, what could we do, what can spirit do except explain it to itself instead of experiencing? We're trying to substitute explanation for experience, is what we're trying to do. Mind is saying, look, I'm gonna be annihilated, you won't have any experiencing, so you're gonna have to just explain. And it's like eating food that there's nothing there. It's like nothing. It's like eating nothing. What the spirit's really saying, you have to get used to nothing and explain this nothing to yourself. And that's going to be your new experiencing, as it were, is explanation. So the fourth dimension is, again, just sophisticated explanation. It's like saying sophisticated nothing. Nothing in a sophisticated guise. That's what it is. It's nothing in a sophisticated guise. And who wants that? Who wants that? That really leads to intense boredom and ennui and a feeling like you just have this terrible feeling of you don't know where to turn. And you say this isn't it, and yet I just feel like it should be it, and I don't know what to do. It's a terrible feeling because you think, oh, it's so sophisticated, how could it not be it? And you think, well, there must be something intrinsically wrong with me. No, there's something intrinsically wrong with explanation. And it's based on spirit wanting to be prime creator. That is where it's all come from. And spirit simply can say, oh, I can accept what I am as I am. I don't need to become something different. I don't need to change what I am. I don't need to be prime creator. I already have everything. I am everything and have everything, just like God has everything and is everything. The only difference is God is primary, that God created spirit and spirit did not create God. That's the only difference. So the great thing of these times is the crystallization of fourth dimension will automatically bring about the crystallization of the fifth dimension too. Both will happen simultaneously as I see it. And that means probably the presence here. It could mean an ascension or something, but it could also mean the presence here of knowing, of being, of knowing, direct knowing, direct acceptance of being, of direct experiencing. That presence could be felt. That could very well happen now. So something tremendous is going to happen. And the thing is, we just have not been clued into it entirely, because there's something that has to do with free will and choice, etc. There's something that has to do with people wanting to see really see if it's really going to happen that way or not. Is the fourth dimension really going to crystallize? Is this really going to happen? And the third dimension is kind of saying, I don't think it will. Maybe it won't. So there's this kind of, we kind of want to see what happens. But once we see it, then we'll say, ah, okay, all right, let's go. Let's go for the fifth now. Yeah, it's all valid. What's going on? What we've been told is now valid. So it's something like it's been held back from us for a little while until we reach a certain point, and then we'll decide, okay, release it to us. Okay, release it to us now. We're willing to have it released to us. You see, the third dimensional's thought, hope, they could break the fourth dimensional grip. And it's very obvious that they could not. I knew that they could not. I knew that they would not be able to. It is a fait accompli. So I did not join those efforts to try to break it. Besides, the third dimension is also based on explanation. It's just that they want to have a variety of explanations instead of being too regimented. It's the same delusion, actually. It's the same delusion. The right and the left have the same delusion. It's just that they have different notions about explanation. One wants to get a uniform explanation, the other wants to have a variety of explanations. They want to have some freedom to change their mind and all this kind of stuff. But it's the same, it's still explanation. So as the fifth dimension, that's the goal, is to dwell in a paradise of enlightenment, glorious enlightenment, of direct experiencing, everything reflecting what we are. No need for any explanation. We can actually experience that right here, anywhere. Right now, we can experience that. We drop the demand for explanation, we will experience it. But it's also possible that there is some dimensional shifting going to take place, some relocation take place. That is certainly possible, because the fourth dimensional situation is very much inimical to fifth dimensional consciousness, very much so. They demand very strong explanation. It's super bureaucratic, super based on laws and legalism, and everybody being put into the same cookie cutter mold. Totalitarianism, fascism, one world dictatorship, all that stuff, that's fourth dimensional. Of course, they see it as is the answer, because they say, we're going to get the right explanation for you. There is no right explanation for what we are. There is no right explanation for what we are, none whatsoever. What we are can only be revealed to us, directly revealed to us. So there is no right explanation. So you must drop the demand for explanation. There is a right explanation as to why we don't need an explanation. Our explanations can't possibly work. That can be explained, and I believe I've done it. But that still means there is no explanation for what we are. Absolutely not. There is no explanation for what we are. What we are can never be explained to us. No way. Not even remotely. Not even remotely. How can nothing explain everything? You know, it's ridiculous. It's totally ridiculous. And again, what we're literally trying to do is substitute explanation for experience. That's literally what we're trying to do. And so the fourth dimension is just the ultimate push to that, to substitute explanation for experience. And third dimensional saying, whoa, wait a minute, I'm not ready for that. I'm not sure I want to go there. Whereas fifth dimensionals know that they don't want to go there. They say, we have an option. Third dimensionals don't know what their option is so much. Fifth dimensionals know what their option is. They say, no, I know that direct seeing, direct knowing of what I am is the only way. The only way to know what I am is through direct experiencing, direct revelation, direct reflection, direct knowing, not explanation. So there's a sense of clarification now, a tremendous sense of clarification. I feel great despite all the stress. I feel like we are now here. We are really here now. And the clarity is going to just go off the charts, even into presence. You know, we're at the door of presence. There are some that have presence in the world. I don't know where they are. Maybe we'll find them. There are others that talk a lot about it and are not in it. But there's a lot of that, that is for sure. But at this point now, we will need those who are actually accepting the presence that is directly revealed to them. And then that will automatically reassure us that we don't need explanation. Automatically bring about this fifth dimensional ascension, as it were. How that plays out, I don't know. But we'll certainly find out. Certainly, it'll certainly be wonderful. Certainly no trouble for us at all. But I don't know how it will play out at this point. The goal has been to get to this point. The four fours, the May 20th deal. Actually, the 19th is the completion of the 4 weeks, right? If you start on the 20th, if you started on the 20th, then 1 month actually ends on the 19th and a new month starts on the 20th. So really, today, the 19th, is the completion of those 4 weeks. So we're already here. It's amazing because on the January 20th, I made a video talking about this is the day. Now we have to make an all-out push. And I did it on the 20th, because the inauguration I thought was on the 21st, but it turns out the inauguration actually took place in private on the 20th. So the taping was exactly right. And then today, I thought, no, tomorrow's the 4-4-4s. It's not, it's actually today. It's actually today. Today is the completion of 4 years and 4 months by present number 44. The 4-4s, the swastika, the fourth dimension. And tomorrow we'll begin the crystallization of that, which should mean then it also begins the fifth dimension, awareness of the fifth dimensional presence here. It's quite strange that the ones who have presence in this world have kind of like disappeared. They've gone into, I don't know where they are. It's really something. I know that it must be here. There must be some, you know, but they're not, they've been hard to find for some reason. Probably coming up, they'll be easier to find. I would think so. That's the hope. That's the promise that I got. The promise that I got is definitely we will be able to come across those who directly know who they are. Directly know without any need of any explanation whatsoever. Imagine that. They don't need any words. They don't need any concepts. They don't even need perception. They directly know what they are. They're directly experiencing what they are every moment, directly experiencing effortlessly. And we can easily do that too. It's not difficult at all. Not difficult. We just have to feel that it's okay to do it. And the problem is the fourth dimensionals say it's not okay. Third dimensionals also. Both the third and the fourth say it's not okay. It's not okay. Whereas the third dimensionals, you can kind of go off and do your own thing. Whereas in fourth dimension, you cannot go off and do your own thing. They will know your location. I mean, it's funny now on the websites I use, they say, we want to know your location. We have permission to access your location. I mean, it's unbelievable. Everybody now wants to know your location. I got that on Yahoo. I got some kind of special message saying all this stuff about privacy and we want to know your location and everything. And of course, Google does that. All the big tech companies, the whole fourth dimensional thing is about knowing your location. What are you doing right now? All the data of your habit patterns, all your likes, everything about you. So that you can be educated to fit into their explanation of what you are. And again, what you are cannot be explained. What you are is entirely beyond the reach of explanation. Entirely beyond the reach of explanation. And will always be entirely beyond the reach of explanation. And yet we can explain why it is we're so attached to explanation. That is what I have done. That has been my life's work, and I have completed it. Completed it yesterday, the May 18th, one day before the 4-4s. Which is why I say I'm always on time, as it were. Always tend to complete things right on the dot for some reason. So I don't have any doubts whatsoever about this explanation of why we are so attached to explanation. And as far as I know, I've never seen it been given out. It's something I had to work on and drop our fears. Say, oh my gosh, this is what we've done. This is what we've done. We tried to substitute explanation for experiencing because we try to be prime creator, and therefore that would cause the annihilation of reality and there wouldn't be anything to experience. So we thought we could just explain what we want to experience. Like dreaming, we could just dream and explain this experiencing to ourselves. Conceptualize it, symbolize it. We can just get by on symbols, which are really explanations. We're trying to explain to us because if we annihilate reality, what other hope do we have for us except to believe that we can simply explain to us what reality is, even though it's not there? You see? So, of course, we're not ready for that. So we want to teach ourselves gradually how to explain, measure, figure everything. As if we can then just, in our mind, the mind can just, we can be without mind, but we can explain to ourselves, if mind were there, how would it be functioning? It's kind of like that. It's really like that. If we didn't have anything, what would we do? Well, we could explain what everything was, even though it wasn't there to be experienced. It's kind of like trying to make everything out of nothing. There's nothing there, and yet we imagine and explain if everything was there, what would it be like? Well, okay. That's what we're trying to do. That's what we've been trying to do. Don't need to do that, because everything will always be there. Everything will always be there. We cannot change reality at all. So all of this is just a fantasy, a make-believe. So that's the good news. That's the gospel. Now, prior to this date, you could expect things, plays would be been made, because after this date, I believe fifth dimensional presence is going to, we're going to call it out, so call it out into the open. We'll release it. We'll say release, and we'll say, okay, we're ready for fifth dimension. We're ready for presence now. We're ready for it. But prior to that, there was just a point just before this where we were still vulnerable to third dimensional consciousness. Of course, we don't want the fourth, but third dimension seemed like an option, right? In some way, we want to escape the fourth, so we thought maybe the third. So there was likely to be one last temptation, and for me there absolutely was. It was a very scary thing. The third dimension tempted me one last time, and fortunately I was able to say no, but it was very awkward and very stressful actually. But so now I expect the fifth dimension consciousness of knowing, being, direct experiencing of what I am, to come out in the open and to be available, and we will know who they are and get the help we need. That's how I see. So if you have made it to this point and you still have this feeling of availability to that, then you've made it. Definitely there was a struggle the last week, and I made it. I did great. But the third dimensional stuff was really trying to tempt me. Said, why don't you get into this? You know, let's have a paradise, a third dimensional paradise. You know, we'll have fun, we'll party, everybody will be tan and recreating, and that's third dimensional stuff. And I said, no. Now's not the time to go in that direction, you know. But the temptations came, really they did. It was quite a struggle. I've been very wary of the situation, and there was a temptation to stop taping, to you know, just cast it all aside and let's try to get the best of the third dimension, you know, the best living that the third dimension has to offer, that kind of thing. Which is ridiculous, because the fourth dimension has, you know, triumphed. And they're going to have things their way, for sure. No question about it. So I was able to continue on. I said, let me just continue. Let me keep trying. Let me keep struggling. And finally, the complete explanation of why we don't need explanations and why we're embracing explanations at all clicked into place. And now I see it and say, ah, okay, piece of cake. But the thing is that we had to at least act like we wanted the third dimension to try to offset the fourth. You know, that's the thing. What I did is I tried to embrace the third dimension because I didn't want the fourth. So, you know, and so that in some ways that protected me from the fourth. But I certainly don't want the third either. And especially on this planet, the third is curtains for the third. That is for sure. It is curtains for the third dimension on this planet. It's over. And that's a tough pill to swallow, really. As you're going through this, you say, oh my gosh, I don't want the fourth. The fourth is terrible. And fortunately, we know about the fifth. We know about direct knowing. We know that we can directly experience what we are. And that's the only way to experience what we are. We can only experience what we are. We cannot have it explained what we are. We are not an explanation. We are not a becoming. We are a being. We are not an explanation. So the promise of a fifth dimension is what enables us to keep going. But certainly the embracing of the third dimension to try to defend against going into the fourth is something that I did. But it also has a troublesome side to it, for sure. For sure. And it's not the answer at all. But I felt a need to do some of that. Just to, you know, push away the fourth, the demands of the fourth. So it's one way to do it, but it's not without its pitfalls, for sure. I guess there are other ways to do it too. There are other ways to do it. Everyone has a slightly unique way of trying to deal with it, but the fourth dimension is, my gosh, it's terrible. It's very sterile. It's very sterile. It's a dead end. It's a dead end. Because you keep pursuing these explanations, you know, investigations, scientific. You measure everything, you quantify everything. Everything's numbers and physics. And you're just trying to explain everything to yourself. Trying to explain it all. And deep down you have this feeling like it's all nothing. It's all nothing. It's nothing. It's just all these sophisticated forms of nothing. And eventually you just feel this just terrible kind of depression. Nihilism, you know, just this horrible, horrible sense of there's just nothing. I'm just dwelling in nothing. And I have no idea what to do about it. It's horrible. Fourth dimension's horrible. Now, the third dimension is got its own horrors for sure. It's terrible also, that's for sure. But it's not as controlled, so there can be, teachers can come into the third dimension and explain the fifth to us. Whereas in the fourth dimension, it's very difficult for teachers to function in that situation. Because it's still all an explanation. And just people think they're enlightened because they think they have an enlightened explanation. Or they think they have an explanation for enlightenment. So they think, well, I must be enlightened. That's where you get the Advaita disease, as it were. Neo-Advaita disease is thinking that they understand the explanation. And that is enlightenment. You say, oh, okay. And it's not it. That is not it. That is not it. It's obvious when you compare someone who's genuinely experiencing directly what they are. Every instant, directly experiencing what they are. And they're in complete bliss. They're just total bliss, seamless bliss. Doesn't matter what the circumstances are. Yogananda commented about Ananda Mahima. She said, it's unbelievable. It's just so incredible because no matter what situation she's in, the bliss is just totally seamless. The highest bliss, completely seamless. There's no change in it whatsoever. He said, that is just so amazing. He says, most of us get that in meditation. We have to meditate for that. But for her, it's effortlessly go driving in a car, talking, visiting, everything is still there completely because everything is directly reflecting, revealing, being. You see? Because in her case, there's no demand for explanation whatsoever. So that is different than thinking that one understands the explanation for enlightenment or something. It's quite different. One who has dropped the demand for explanation is literally in bliss all the time, effortlessly. It's not something to get in meditation. It's there all the time. And that's the genuine fifth dimensional consciousness. I might call it the high fifth dimension, maybe, or something. Maybe the fifth dimension may be that there are those who need to meditate and get it bit by bit or something, or get into it and then try to clarify, etc. But there definitely is a state where it's a constant, seamless, effortless, because there's no demands for explanation. All the demands for explanation have been dropped. And then everything directly reveals direct experience, and then the self says, that's paradise, that's reality, that's what I am. I am the one who directly experiences. You see, what are we? What is our identity? We are the one that directly experiences what we are. That is what we are. The direct experiencing is what we are. And what we are can never be harmed or changed by what we experience at all. It's always a direct, complete experiencing, and there isn't anything other than that direct experiencing. It's all one. Wherever we are directly experiencing everything. There's no such thing as we're directly experiencing something, but not something else. No. Everything, the whole totality, the entire creation, we are directly experiencing. There is no stratification, no layers, no levels, anything like that. It is direct knowing, direct experiencing. We are the ones that directly experience. So obviously explanation doesn't work at all for us. Cannot. We were not created for explanation. We were created for direct experiencing. All right. So we certainly know one who is in direct experiencing. This is unmistakable. They're in this incredible bliss all the time, no matter what. In my looking at the world right now, I don't see that. Those who are talking about enlightenment, etc., I don't see that. They're not. It's obvious they're not. They may have had a glimpse of it. They may be able to get into it, touch upon it at times in meditation, which is all great. It's all wonderful. That is fine. No problem. However, what we deserve is those who are in it, actually in it, have dropped all demands for explanation. That is what we deserve at this point. That is what we should expect at this point. We absolutely should expect that. And that's not any trouble for us. I don't feel why it would be any trouble for us at all. So if you come up, the great guru is simply one who's dropped all demands for explanation of what they are. That's it. So it's simple. You have to ask them all sorts of questions. Not really, you know exactly what they're about. They've dropped the demands for explanation of what they are. No demands. It's all they're directly experiencing. And that is what we are. Not through words, not through concepts, not through even through bodily perception, actually, because bodily perception itself is an interpretation. It is itself an explanation, actually. Our perception, flesh, is an explanation. It's part of the explanation process. There actually, we have spiritual senses, actually perception, that can see spiritually. And on my mom said she didn't see, use the body's eyes for seeing. She could, but see, what she was seeing as directly, she says, is coming to me through spiritual perception, not the flesh of the body, not the consciousness of the body. Didn't even identify with it. So we have a spiritual perception. We have a spiritual perception. Direct experiencing. And we call it direct perception. That might be an intermediate step, but we don't. That's already been explained. Well, I can explain that easily. But the senses are, again, part of the explanation of what we are. It's not direct. We're not directly experiencing. It's part of an explanation of what we are. That the body and the senses, all part of an explanation of what we are. Which, again, what we are can never be explained. Absolutely not. But there, don't equate the loss of the body, the death of the body, with salvation then. They're not equated with that. Because there are subtle levels of explanation too, subtle bodies. And so you're still having it explained to you after the death of this flesh. You're still having it explained to you what you are, not directly experiencing what you are at all, through these subtle bodies. And then these subtle bodies will again put on a flesh body, which is, again, just more explanation of what you are. So the death of the body is not the answer at all. It is not. It's the dropping the demand for explanation that is salvation. That's it. Dropping the demand for explanation of what we are is salvation. That's it. And of course we want reassurance about, okay, is this the right thing to do? And then explanation of why we don't need explanation is helpful. That's very helpful. But the actual presence of those who have dropped the demand is extraordinarily helpful, especially for those who already have the context and understanding clear. That's very helpful. So we will see what happens. But we are now at the time where I do expect some of this happening to take place in some way, in some fashion. There's going to be change now. There is going to be change. The patterns that we've been stuck in, the ruts that we've been stuck in, I really expect those to dissolve, really. Because we will realize, well, the fifth dimensional will come to us and say, hey, what do you think now? And we say, hey, yeah, that's what I want. I understand now. I see what's happening. Definitely, you're right. You had it right all along. I just wanted to double check it. But now we see the utility of it. We see how the usage of it. We say, oh, this is definitely the help that we need. Whereas before, we might have swung over to the third dimension. We say, well, maybe this is going to help us solidify in the third dimension. But now we see the third dimension is kaput. Now, we're not going to use it that way. We're not going to say, oh, this is some way to help us get more rooted in the third dimension. See, that's the problem we had. That's the problem I had. That's why it didn't happen for me yet, because I would have been tempted to use it to try to get more rooted in the third dimension, you see. And that's what we had to overcome, that temptation. And hopefully it has been overcome. I hope so. It's on its way out. So the ruts that we've been stuck in, likely to dissolve now. Very likely to dissolve. Which is a great thing. A little cool down. So again, it's the worst of times, it's the best of times, literally. It's the day of triumph for the fourth dimension, over the third, which is, some would say that's the worst of times. The control of the fourth dimension on this planet now is, some would say that's the absolute worst of times. However, by seeing that this is now happened, those who don't want that can say, hey, now we are willing to accept the help to go to the fifth dimension. So it's the best of times in that way, you see? It really is. That's how you make, boy, that's sour, it's too strong. Make lemonade, and we can now make lemonade. Start drinking lemonade. Maybe it's time to start drinking lemonade, actually. Very purifying lemonade. Maybe I'll start drinking. Let's start drinking lemonade. Because that's like that. I mean, fourth dimension is a lemon, a real lemon, a real clunker. But now that we see the clunker, it's like we have this car. It's like, here's your car. We look at it and say, what? That clunker, that piece of junk, I don't want that car. And we say, no way am I going to drive that car. And then you start looking around like, oh, I'm looking for another car. And then you see another car, and it's a wonderful car, and say, ah, I want that car. I'm going to get that car. So it's great. It's great when you don't get what you want, or something that you don't want at all, because then you look for something else. So the situation we have now is the awareness that the third dimension has been defeated is now going to make us realize, uh-oh, I was hoping maybe the third dimension wouldn't be defeated because I could stay with that. And now we realize, uh-oh, it's the fourth. You know, either I'm going to the fourth, and you say, no way. And then we're going to say, okay, let's look for an option. I can't have the third. The fourth is what I'm being presented with. Let's look for the fifth. Let's look for the fifth. Yes, we can. That is the truth. Yes, we can. Yes, we can get the fifth. The fifth dimension, yes, we can. So we have to stay strong in that realization that it's not disaster, it's not the end of the world, it's not terrible, even though things are now suddenly, it's like fourth dimension is going to, you know, clamp down. And say, this is it. Fourth dimension will say, basically, what the fourth dimension will say is, this is it for you and for everyone. That's it. Nothing else. This is it. There isn't anything else. That's what they'll say. And anyone who thinks there's something else is a criminal and will be dealt with very harshly. That's what's coming. And what we can say is, we don't want that. That's terrible. Let's look for an alternative, and then the fifth dimension will say, here we are, here's the fifth, direct knowing of what we are. Drop the demand for explanation of what we are. And so that's beneficial, super beneficial. It's a greatly beneficial time for us now, greatly beneficial. And we've been saying goodbye to the third for a long time. It's been a long process, a terrible process, really, of realizing that, hey, this may be over. The third dimensional thing may be over. And it's like, you know, we're kind of used to it. You know, it was kind of interesting, kind of fun. But an idea that we're losing it has been a tough thing, very tough. But hopefully by now, we have adjusted to it and say, okay, I see the bigger picture now. And it really was not that great at all. It was just a little bit better maybe than the fourth, you know, but by itself is really not great at all. And so it's not that big of a deal, because the fifth is just way, way better. You know, it's just way, way better. So it's not like we're losing quality at all. We're going to gain immeasurable quality by the fifth dimension, immeasurable quality we're going to gain. It's just like the third dimensions don't like losing to the fourth. You know, they don't like that. They don't like the imposition, you know, being imposed upon like that. They don't like it. But that's the price you pay for demanding explanation, is that you are going to get imposition at some point of the fourth dimension. You're going to get that. That's just the price you pay. So now that we see that, realize it, we realize, oh, the third wasn't that great, because at some point the fourth is going to be imposed upon it. And so it never, that was a fait accompli. It was bound to happen. And we say, okay, that third's not so great. Not at all. Not at all. Let's go to the fifth. Let's go to the fifth. So, pretty amazing. You wonder, how's the Holy Spirit work? It is amazing, really. We don't understand at this point. Here's an example. There was somebody that worked as just an office person at a place that I needed to go to several times, and this person always struck me as, like, I said, you know what, I like that person. There's something about them that I just like their spirit. There's something about them. I feel like somehow they're beneficial to me. I don't know how. I just said, I feel that way. So on the very day that I was severely tempted and really in turmoil and by the third dimension, I happened to be in that place, and this person was walking past, and they don't even know me or anything. Never, you know, introduced myself or anything, and they shouted out to someone else that was behind me, and I thought they were shouting to me. They yelled, he says, remember, 55, 55, you can do it, you can do it. They weren't talking to me, they were yelling to someone behind me, but what they said was exactly what I needed to hear. That is suddenly, oh my gosh, I know I can do it, and that broke the spell, the temptation. So that person actually turned out to be extremely helpful for me. And that the feeling I had about them previously, I said, I know that somehow they're going to be very, this person is a very helpful person. It turned out that they were very helpful. Amazing thing. I have no idea what their name is or anything. But I just got this vibe from them that somehow they're going to be helpful to me. And they said exactly the right thing at exactly the right moment. That clicked for me and made me realize, yes, I can. I can reach the fifth dimension. Yes, I can do it. Incredible. Incredible. That's the Holy Spirit at work. See, the Holy Spirit works in ways that are so amazing that there's no way we can really quite explain it to us. You know, we are hooked into explanation. Can't explain how the Holy Spirit works. Because it's the master. And it uses time to help us, free us of time. It uses explanation to free us from explanation. It uses circumstance to free us from dependency on circumstance, etc. It's the great orchestrator. And something like that was just astonishing. Just astonishing. It gave me that boost, just a little boost at exactly the right moment that I was able to decide to keep pushing on. Whereas I may have crumbled. I was so severely in such turmoil, I may have crumbled if I hadn't had that. You know, just as reminded me, the Holy Spirit said, hey, yes, you can. You can do it. You're going to do it. I know you can. I know you can do it. And then I managed to stabilize and keep taping and keep making this effort, which has now resulted in a total clarity about the situation and the capacity to share it. And by the way, at the same time, all of my means to share this on the computer broke down. They all broke down. And I previously purchased this camera on a whim almost. I mean, there was this newspaper in the kitchen that was happened to be open, turned upside down, and there's this advertising for Fry's Electronics of this camera. And I never look at that stuff. Never, ever do I look, pay any attention. For some reason, I just picked it up and looked at this, and there's a camcorder there, and I just said, huh, what's that? I'm not interested in a camcorder. And then, because one of the viewers here has pointed out to me the audio was choppy, you know, and I was having trouble in with communicating these videos, I sort of thought, hey, maybe I should pay attention to this camcorder. And then I happened to go to the store, and again, like I told you, there was just one left that was under the desk. And they said, we all sold out. Oh, we just found one. It's the last one, $99. And I said, oh my gosh, maybe I can buy it. Not that I can even afford that, but I said it's important, very important. And then after that, all the ways of communicating broke down on my computer. Ustream stopped working. The audio stopped working, choppy. Can't get it to work. Direct uploading to YouTube is very iffy, and it kept saying, disconnection, no connection, no connection, try again, no connection. It's way, totally unreliable. And then direct recording to my computer also became unreliable, also became totally unreliable and didn't work anymore. So the only way I have to really communicate this is by direct taping to this camcorder, which I just, an amazing string of events, I purchased. It's just like, you know, it's the Holy Spirit arranging that kind of stuff. That newspaper just happened to be there. I just happened to glance at it, and my mind just said, huh, maybe I should think about this. And it just happened that I had one left, otherwise I wouldn't have got it. I'd be stuck, as it were. Pretty much stuck. So, again, the Holy Spirit coming to the rescue. I'm out of water. And of course, this is a lot more work. I have to upload these in 20-minute segments. That's all that the camera takes, 20-minute segments. So I have to upload these individually, and the file size is huge. And then edit them together in YouTube Editor, and then render that also. So it's a lot more involved than just direct recording to Ustream, which is just one, and then click, and then uploads it, done, super fast. But, you know, that's, at least we have this now. So there was that turmoil going on. There was the temptation of the third dimension trying to tempt me to stick with the third dimension. That was going on. And all sorts of other stuff was going on. Other people around me are all sick too now. They're struggling too. Everybody's struggling. And that boost, hey, you can do it. 55, fifth dimension. You can do it. Come on. I said, okay, yeah, I can do it. So here we are. We've done it. We have made it this far, and withstood the temptation, got the clarification, knowing it's just all about dropping the demand for explanation. Drop the demand for explanation. Drop the demand for explanation. I am, and time isn't. In other words, drop the demand for explanation. We don't need any explanation for what we are. Drop the demand. We don't need it. It only, this feeling we need it only has arisen out of our desire to be prime creator, and we don't need to be prime creator. We can drop that idea. We can change the idea to, let's not be prime creator. Let's let God be God and let us be spirit. And within that is eternity, eternal life, everything, experience of everything, always, directly. And that is what we are, and that is what we've always been, and always will be. And this whole side trip into demanding explanation, relying on explanation, trying to substitute explanation for experiencing, it's just been a hypothetical scenario. What if kind of thing? What if this were possible? What if it were possible? So again, we're not going back to the third dimension. We're certainly not going along with the fourth dimension. Going to the fifth dimensional experience, which is all about dropping the demand for explanation. Be oriented in that direction. I don't know if you have to actually drop the demand in order to go to the fifth dimension. I kind of doubt it. But you have to be oriented in that direction. The preponderance of you is saying, ah, okay, I'm dropping the third and the fourth. So I'm accepting the orientation where that is allowed. In the fifth dimension, you have the teachers for sure who have dropped the demand entirely for explanation of what they are. And that has totally enabled this willingness to drop the demand for explanation is totally enabled there, totally enabled. So we're able to go along in that direction very successfully. But I would doubt that you have to first drop it all in order to go to the fifth dimension, because who's going to do that here? Very few, really. That's in this present situation in the world, that is very difficult. There's a lot of intimidation going on not to do that. You just have to have a willingness to do that. Okay? If you had literally dropped the demand for all explanation for what you are, you wouldn't even need the fifth dimension. You wouldn't even need it. So, I would say it's simply a willingness. And to say, no, I'm not going with the third anymore, definitely not the fourth, it's the fifth. The willingness to do this. That's all that's needed. That's all that's needed. And of course, there's a lot of people who are willing. It's just a seesaw, you know, it pivots, and there's the weight, the scales. You say, there's more of me that says I'm willing to do that. And it's not a problem. I'm not bothered by letting go of the third and the fourth dimension. That's it. I'm not bothered by that, because those are all demands for explanation. So be reassured at this point. Be reassured. Just waiting to see if there's anything else. But again, best of times, worst of times, best of times. Yes, it's the writing is now on the wall, yes. But that's a good thing. We don't like what it's saying, so I say, okay, we'll go different wall, different writing. So hopefully I've helped pave the way. This work, and actually you, the viewers, are just as much responsible, really. There's no teaching without those who want the teaching. There's no clarification without those who want it and find it useful. If nobody found it useful, I wouldn't have done it. You know, I tried doing it with no responses, and I gave up, because it was the use. You know, it's like ridiculous. It's just ridiculous. But now that I got responses on this channel, you know, I said, let me keep trying, because there's a response there. So really, it's a collective effort here of those who say, yeah, I want to get the fifth dimension. That, yeah, it's important. That's what I want. Then that brings out the best in all of us. And I say, well, I got the capacity. I happen to have a situation where I'm able to do this. The circumstances are such, I'm able to do this. So I said, let me make right use of time, right use of mind. Let me actually do all this taping. I don't know, it's like 350 videos on this channel alone, and I don't know how many hours. It's been an incredible effort, but worthwhile effort. And the effort was made possible because there are those who enjoy viewing them and considering all this and benefiting from it. So it's been a great situation. And the best is yet to come, for sure. The best is yet to come, and I don't know exactly what it's going to be. But we will find out very soon, so be reassured of that. All right, let's call it a day on this one. Let's call it a day. Now I got to upload it and do all that kind of stuff. That'll take all day to upload this, for sure. Okay, very great, that's it.